Let me ask you about some of the things that came up in the documentary.
Right. Well, I haven't seen it, so you...
But this happened in your life, so you know about this. The Times let you go after you made up a quote. Why did you make up a quote?
Well, this again, you know, these are big terms for what happened. Well, I can tell you the whole thing. I mean, are you sure our viewers wouldn't want to hear more about
it was a
long and lamentable story.
Okay, but you made it quick.
Well, what happened was that I ascribed events that were supposed to have taken place before the death of Piers Gaveston to events that actually took place after the death.
You made
of Piers
something Gaveston. Up. Let me ask you about another little.
I mean, I mildly sandpapered something.
Let me ask
said,
you about a barefaced lie.
It was very
lie,
embarrassing.
Though.
I'm very sorry about
Let
it.
Let me ask you about a barefaced lie. When you were in Michael Howard's team, you denied to him you were having an affair. It turned out you were, and he sacked you for that. Why did you lie to your party?
Well, I mean, again, I mean, with great respect on that, I never had any conversation with Michael Howard about that matter, and you know, I don't.
You did lie.
Propose to. Well, you know, I don't propose to go into all that again.
I don't blame you.
No, well, why should I? I mean, I've been through, you know, that question a lot with watch the documentary.
Okay.
Why don't we talk about something else?
The program also includes, well, this is about your integrity.
Okay.
The program includes your reaction as you listen to a phone call in which your friend, Darius Guppy, asks you to supply the address of a journalist so that he can have him physically assaulted. The words beaten up and broken ribs are said to him. And you, having heard that, you tell your friend, Darius Guppy, you will supply the address. What does that say about you, Boris Johnson?
Well,
aren't you, in fact, making up quotes, lying to your party leader, wanting to be part of someone being physically assaulted? You're a nasty piece of work, aren't you?
Well, I think all three things I would dispute.
Well, you don't factually dispute them.
Well, I do, and I could, you know, if we had a long time, which we don't, I could explain that I think all three interpretations you're putting on those things aren't wholly fair. And certainly the final thing which you raise, which is the case of my old friend Darius. Yes, it was certainly true that he was in a bit of a state, and I did humour him in a long phone conversation from which absolutely nothing eventuated. And, you know, there you go. But I think if any of us had our phone conversations bugged, they might, you know, people say all sorts of fantastical things whilst they're talking to their friends.
But even Conrad Black, your friend, convicted fraudster, even he says he doesn't trust you completely.
I hadn't seen that Conrad had said that, but obviously, nonetheless, I've got a great admiration for Conrad, who, in my view, is a pretty good journalist.